Well, night three of the Republican National Convention, just hours away. Here now to discuss everything we should look out for and some of the things we have seen already from this week's program is Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger. Sir, thank you so much for being here. This is a break from tradition. We are not just seeing, but hearing from President Trump every single night of this convention. Do you like that idea? Is it a good strategy? And is it working so far?
I think we'll be able to tell in the post if it's working. I think so. I thought that, I haven't watched all the convention, quite honestly, but I thought the hostages video he did, for instance, was really pretty. I thought that was pretty interesting and pretty cool. I think it'll depend when his main speech happens, but I think it's definitely different because, obviously in past conventions, everything is a build up to the big moment when the nominee or the president comes out. So, but I do think, look, there's, If you don't like Republicans, you're going to look at this convention and say, this is terrible. If you love them, you're going to say, this is amazing. I think the reality is given the situation, it's probably pretty good. I think given the fact that we have COVID and it's all by distance.
Now, you just said you haven't been watching all of it. I don't think you're supposed to admit that, are you, Congressman?
I can admit that.
But hey, the keynote, of course, is tomorrow night with the president. And we've gotten word that a couple of folks that will be there are two House GOP candidates who subscribe to this conspiracy group QAnon. That's been in the news quite a bit lately, but they have been invited to the keynote. What are your thoughts now on them being there and also this QAnon group that's really, like a lot of people are buzzing about it these days?
Look, I certainly wouldn't have invited them. I'm sure that the White House has invited every candidate. Look, I mean, a district has a right to put somebody that believes whatever they want into Congress. So they have, they have a right to be seated. But as a party, as a Republican party, we have got to defend, our principles and our beliefs. QAnon is nuts. Their belief system that the government is run by Satanist pedophiles and not by your vote, not by, we the people, not by Congress, but by this underground. That is what's dangerous in the long run.
Look, based on what I know, you haven't seen a lot of it, but I know you've been watching the coverage and reading a lot of the coverage as well. What is so far, in your opinion, the theme of this convention? Is it trying to appeal to the base, which is, I guess, is what most conventions do? But also, has it done enough to branch out, to widen that appeal?
So I've actually been fairly pleased with the attempt to widen the appeal. I've been one of these that say, the Republican Party has to continue to grow because the base win is only going to happen maybe another election cycle or two. I think they've done a lot. Look, I'm a huge fan of Tim Scott. He and I have been buddies. We were elected together into the House of Representatives. His speech blew me away, and I knew his story, but I got teary-eyed hearing it again, A guy that was given no chance, now a U.S. senator. I think those are the kind of stories and the real Americans that are going to reflect well on people. I'm not sure if the convention on either side is really going to make or break a president, but I definitely think the Republicans are doing what we should be doing in this kind of moment.
All right, Congressman Kinzinger, good to see you. Thank you so much. And you better turn that TV on. Don't stop admitting that you're not watching your convention, my man.
Slouching.
All right, thanks so much. You take care.